Hello friends, in this video we will try and understand the basic meaning of watermarking and the general block diagram of a digital watermarking system. Now what is watermarking? Now watermarking is basically a logo or a kind of a design which is actually impressed on a piece of paper. Now why do we do watermarking? Now watermarking is actually done in order to identify the content creator or to identify the source of information and is basically used for copyright protection, isn't it? So therefore, when we talk about watermarking in general, it is basically a design or a logo which is actually impressed on a piece of paper or a document. And why do we use it? Now we use it to identify the source and basically is used for copyright identification. So this is watermarking in general. But now when we talk about digital watermarking, so when you have an image, so when you have digital data, so today because of digitization it is very easy to make copies, digital copies of the information or data without any loss of information. So in order to identify the source or in order to identify the content creator and for copyright protection, we have watermarking. So and that is definitely referred to as digital watermarking. So what is digital watermarking? In digital watermarking, you have some kind of an information which is actually embedded into an image. And that is referred to as digital watermarking. So when we talk about digital watermarking, I'll write it as DM. So digital watermarking is a tool which is actually used to identify the source. So we can identify the source, is actually used to identify the creator of the data, meaning that we will be able to identify the owner. So basically it is also used to identify the owner or the source or the content creator, and definitely is also used for copyright protection. And why do we do it? So this is actually done to identify if there are any illegal copies of the digital data which is being done. So therefore it is actually used to identify if the digital data or the image has been reproduced or has been distributed illegally. So if the digital data has been distributed or modified illegally, and this is the use of digital watermarking. So digital watermarking is a process where we have some data, so the data is actually embedded in an image which is imperceptible to the human eye, which is imperceptible to the image observers. So when you have some kind of a data which is embedded into the image in such a way that it is not visible, imperceptible meaning it is not visible to the observers, then that is referred to as digital watermarking. And why do we do digital watermarking? It is actually done to identify if the data or the image has been distributed or has been modified illegally, and is also used to identify the source, the creator or the owner. And the most important thing is, of course, this, that is to avoid illegal distribution, illegal modification of the data, and of course it provides copyright identification, right? So any digital watermarking system will have all these basic processes. So let's go through the digital watermarking system block diagram which has been drawn here. So we have the original image which is H, and then there is a watermark. So watermark is a unique data which is actually embedded inside the original image, which is imperceptible. So what happens here? You have the original image and the watermark is actually embedded inside the original image, which is usually imperceptible to the human eye. That means it is not visible. So when you view the watermark image, then it is not possible for us to identify the presence of the watermark. Now how do you embed the watermark inside the original image? We use a secret key. So secret key is actually used to make sure that the watermark information is embedded inside the original image, which provides the watermark image. So you have the watermark image, and to any general observer, the original image H and the watermarked image almost looks the same. So now this watermarked image is received at the receiving end. So the watermarked image moves along the communication channel, and at the receiving end we may need to extract the watermark. In order to extract the watermark, the same secret key is used to extract the watermark from the watermarked image. So the process of embedding is done in such a way that a key is used, and similarly here the process of extraction also requires the same secret key. So here the process of watermarking can be coupled with the process of encryption, and it can have a number of uses, varied uses, which we shall discuss much later. So therefore, if you observe the entire block diagram of a digital watermarking system, the digital watermarking system has two major steps. Now what are they? The first one is watermark embedding. Now what is watermark embedding? It is a process where the watermark is inserted into the original, or it is also referred to as the host image. So the process of embedding the watermark into the original image or the host image is referred to as watermark embedding. And the second one is, of course, watermark extraction. It is a process in which the watermark is extracted out of the image. So that is what we observe here. So this happens at the receiving end. So where the watermark is extracted from the watermarked image by using the same secret key which was used in the process of embedding. So the whole process of digital watermarking, complemented with encryption, can serve a large number of purposes, such as copyright protection, broadcast monitoring, data authentication, and so on and so forth. So in the next video segment, we shall see what are the different classifications of watermark, how watermark can be classified into various categories. We should see that in the next video segment. So do not forget to like, share and subscribe, and press the bell icon to get notifications of all the further uploads, and to view all the other videos in cryptography, network security and digital watermarking, steganography. Do not forget to click on the eye icon or go through the playlist, cryptography and network security, and thanks for watching.